We talked a little bit about how to monitor performance for Azure SQL. Let's look at an example. In this example, I have an Azure SQL database already deployed as a general purpose service tier with two vCores. And I'm showing in front of you a very familiar tool to all of you, that is SQL Server Management Studio. And I've got one of those familiar DMV queries up in front of me right here to show you how to monitor active requests for an application. Let's take a look at an example of how to monitor performance for an application running against Azure SQL and see if we can spot some possible problems with it. So from my command line, I'm going to kick off my workload and I'll tell you a little bit about how I'm running this workload. So let me start it off and run it, and let's go monitor it with Management Studio. So you run this DMV set of queries and you're going to see something very familiar to you. You may have seen before things like runnable and things like SOS scheduler yield wait types when you're running queries and monitoring activity against a SQL server, in this case, Azure SQL database. So if you look at this and you want to go look at a different query to see resource usage, we can use the new DMV, DMDB resource stats. This is going to show me on a every 15 second snapshot against my Azure SQL database, what is my CPU, IO, memory consumption, log consumption against my Azure SQL database? And if I click this a couple of times, you're going to see something interesting about this pattern. Notice here in both these intervals, I'm using almost 100% of the CPU for my Azure SQL database. You click back again here with exec request, you can see it is still running and chewing up those kind of CPU resources. Let's look at what the workload actually is. So this is an example of using the OSTRES tool. I've used this in so many demonstrations over the years. Open source tool you can download to run a series of queries. In this case, I'm connecting to my Azure SQL database server, running this query workload, logged in with 10 users, each running it in two iterations or cycles. So 10 users concurrently running this query. Here's what the actual query looks like. It's not that sophisticated. I'm actually using, in this case, I'm assigning the value to a variable, kind of avoid any latencies from result set processing. So I'm really pushing any CPU resources that this query needs onto the back end of SQL Server, running this in a loop. So I come back over here and I can see the query is still executing, but it's finished now. And if you look at this point, you can see this query has run in a minute and 43 seconds. Well, is that bad or good? If you go back and look at the monitoring, the results I had, remember we had a lot of runnable queries and waits on SOS scheduler yield. What does that really mean? So let's go look at the query store in Management Studio. You've probably seen this tool before from SQL Server. And I'll look at my top resource performing queries. In this case, this query ID represents that workload I just showed you. Now, what do the statistics of this query look like? Let's hover over here and look at the plan for a second, and we'll see some interesting statistics for us. Number one, it's been run quite a few times. That's our number one running query on this database. And the average duration is almost like 5 milliseconds. Well, is that a big deal? Well, as it turns out for this workload, that's too slow for me. And based on the fact that I had a lot of runnable status queries with SOS scheduler yield wait types, I kind of suspicious that CPU might be a bottleneck for my application. Query store can help you further. I can look at query wait statistics and see that sure enough, the top wait type for this application is indeed CPU. So this is really an example of a running scenario where I'm seeing that I've got a lot of running queries, but I'm bottlenecked on CPU resources. I can further prove that by clicking here and seeing that indeed the query waiting on CPU is my workload query. And in fact, I can tell that out of the almost 5 milliseconds, almost 4 of it is waiting on CPU. So another way to monitor this workload besides DMV queries that you're used to or using query store through a Management Studio is looking at the Azure portal. Remember I mentioned that in a previous video that Azure Monitor can be used to look at your workload. And sure enough, you can see it from Azure Monitor that the SQL workload for CPU is like at 100% during this time frame. This is really awesome. This is Azure Metrics as part of Azure Monitor, automatically integrate with my Azure SQL deployment, showing me almost like a perfmon graph of compute utilization for my Azure SQL database deployment. One other thing I wanted to show you is that, let's say you want to see a history of compute utilization over time. I can go down here in the portal and click on logs, and I'm going to automatically, by deploying Azure SQL database, get a series of log information that's collected in Azure Monitor behind the scenes. And then I can do something called CUSTO queries. These are queries that allow me to look at metrics, things like CPU percentage against my Azure database over time. And I can see here that yesterday I was running a query and I was getting a similar type behavior for compute utilization. So I can use Azure Metrics to look at things a little bit more real time over like maybe in the last week, last hour, last 30 minutes, or use something like Kusto with logging for Azure Monitor to look at the compute percentage or CPU percentage of my application for Azure Database over a long period of time. So here's an example of monitoring with Azure SQL. Look familiar to you? Management Studio, DMV queries, Query Store, all what you're used to. In this particular case, you can see here, we don't have enough CPU resources for this application. I can look at it through DMVs, through Management Studio, or through Azure Monitor and logging. Stay tuned for our next video where we'll see how to scale our application and improve performance.